Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this Nestlé Health Science-sponsored symposium on the topic of unraveling the science strategies to maintain muscle strength and mobility when aging. First and foremost, I want to thank Nestlé Health Science for sponsoring this symposium, which I hope you'll find interesting. And then thank Stephanie for organizing everything with her usual proficiency. These are my disclosures. When I was told that I had 10 minutes, not 2 minutes, but 10, then I thought, well, something that my boss used to say, then you have to give not just the introduction, but a series of introductory remarks, things that I believe that may be of use for those of you who are involved in the work of involving nutrition, 21st century nutrition, into the clinical advantage to the patient. So I thought of four ideas. First, when to intervene, when do we have to act? Second, beware this is complex. And I'll give you an example on the antagonistic pleiotropy. Three, the idea of minimal nutrition as opposed to optimal nutrition. And I'll give you an example. And finally, just an example of a trial that we've been performing with Nestlé Health Science on multi-approach, not just give one approach, nutrition, but nutrition, exercise, and others. When to intervene? Well, I put this slide in. This is the only one I'm repeating in my lecture earlier in the meeting. If you wait until the patient is really ill, then it's too late. I mean, it's going to be less efficient. You cure Alzheimer's. We hope in the future it not cure, you control Alzheimer's, and then the patient has cancer, or diabetes, or hypertension, or arthritis, etc. The time to intervene is, if you can, find the transition from old robust to old frail. And the frailty is a concept that you, the geriatricians, know very well. Then is when you have to intervene to promote health span and delay the diseases. Don't wait until the patient is really has an age-associated disease. This is the first idea. The second is, but this is very complex. It's not easy to say, all right, have a nice nutrition and a little bit of exercise, no? This, and I wanted to forward to you this concept. This was put forward in the 60s by Sir Peter Medawar. He got the Nobel Prize for the transplant, work on transplant, and he's spoken of as one of the most intelligent persons in the whole UK of the 20th century. And he wrote many very interesting books. And he just came with this idea that the antagonistic pleiotropy happens when one gene that is beneficial for something is bad for something else. So we have developed genes and adaptations to develop, to grow, to reproduce, not to age. After you pass the reproductory age, who cares about that? So when you are going to devise procedures for the old or to age well, remember that there may be genes, and there are examples, that you have to realize that what you do for the young may not be good for the old. Simply not. Because we have developed adaptations to grow, not to age. And this is what Sir Peter developed as the antagonistic pleiotropy. So pleiotropy, one gene has many functions that are antagonistic. Good good for you when you develop an age, but then bad when you're old. So you don't face a trivial problem. My third point is minimal versus optimal nutrition. This is something probably you know, but I more or less developed. In the mid 20th century and late 20th century, when I was studying, the idea was the minimal nutrition. And this came from the time of this. This is another giant. This was Sir Frederick Goland Hopkins, who got the Nobel Prize, and I literally quote, for his discovery of the growth-stimulating vitamins. In the 20th century, we aimed at the minimal requirements, minimal protein requirements, minimal vitamin requirements, for what? To grow. And they stopped there. 20th century, we want optimal nutrition, improve performance, delay aging, and or prevent diseases. There's this paper in Cell by Walter Longo that you might like to have a look at. So not only do you have a difficult task because of the antagonistic pleiotropies and other problems, but also you want to realize that you want to optimize nutrition, not just give the minimal, that's minimal tables, all these things we had in the book when I was young and you were not born. No. You want optimal nutrition. Or you will end up with like this. This is in the very serious magazine, The Economist, a few years ago, they realized that unless you changed our concepts, we're going to end like this. And finally, just wanted to show, because we're here, and an idea that we developed with Nuria Marcons, who is there, the idea of multi-approach. In a complex situation like aging or this age-associated diseases like Alzheimer's, you don't want to attack just one thing. In this case, we had exercise and nutrition for undernourished people. And the results, it's not my aim to describe this, but just to tell you, the number of falls that geriatricians are so much involved in decreases when you feed with supplements and an exercise program. The frailty decreases, and the biological age increases, or shall I say, is maintained. This is done by Steve Horvath, in collaboration with the lab. Dr. Horvath, now in Los Altos, developed a biological clock by studying the DNA methylation. When you study methylation, people, controls, grow older 6 months, but people who take the supplement plus exercise maintain their biological age. So the four ideas: intervention for age-associated diseases, the complexities, the idea of the optimal nutrition, and finally, the multifactorial intervention. Attack the problem from many sides. You'll be much more successful. With these introductory remarks, now I come to my introduction to the speakers, Professor Tommy Söderholm from Stockholm, Sweden, and Uppsala. Then Professor Emma Stevenson from Newcastle. And then not here, but listening to us and ready to answer questions. So it's not just recorded and goodbye. Professor Henrotin from Belgium will also be speaking about the topic that I show here. So thank you very much for your attention, and I give the word to the first speaker, Professor Tommy Henrotin.